Hi, I'm Bob Stern. I'm the principal petrologist here at Keysight Technologies. I'd like to tell you a little bit about some of the key standards lab activities that are going on in our Loveland, Colorado laboratory. This lab was built from the ground up to calibrate our highest performance 8.5-digit multimeters, model 3458A. When we were developing this in the early 80s, we actually collaborated at the time with NIST, and when they were first inventing the Josephson Junction DC reference, HP at the time actually needed that accuracy in order to be able to fully calibrate the DC volts measurement capability of the 3458A. In Loveland, we have been continuously operating a Josephson Junction ever since the early 80s. And this is the Keysight quantum volt intrinsic standard. Today, there are over 20 Josephson Junctions at various locations within the Americas, and we actively participate in those inter-lab comparisons. If you're thinking about accurate DC generation, then clearly the primary standard is a Josephson Junction. One step removed from that is the 10-volt Zener references that you may most commonly know as, say, a Fluke Model 732. Now let's walk into the lab. As you enter, you'll see there's copper tubing around the door, and it's completely electrically isolated. This is all important because of the types of low-level measurements that we're making on the 3458A. Now you're looking inside of the measuring area. If you look closely, you'll see a few items hanging from the ceiling. There are temperature sensors spread around the ceiling so that regardless of where a 3458 is placed within this location, we know absolutely that the temperature in that area is 23 degrees plus or minus 1 degree C. There are some other things that we can do in this lab besides 3458As, and one of them is thermal voltage converters. We can do thermal voltage converters from Ballantyne, from HP, or even precision measurement. And we have very good accuracy or very low measurement uncertainty. So if you have thermal voltage converters and you're wanting to send them out for accurate calibrations, please consider our Loveland, Colorado site for those. If you have 3458As, we send all of our 3458As, we send them to Loveland, Colorado. So I guess what I would say is, if you're not already sending your 3458 to Loveland, you might want to think about doing that in the future. This lab also has other capabilities. We can calibrate 10-volt Zener reference diodes, such as the Fluke 732. We're in a position to do four terminal pairs, so this would be resistance and capacitor standards. And in fact, we can even do voltmeter calibrators. So there's a number of really good capabilities that this lab has, and I hope that you'll consider looking at it when you're thinking about getting calibration of these items in the future. Before I leave, I'd like to review the key deliverables that you'll receive regardless of which discipline we are operating in, both the calibration report and the calibration certificate. So let's just take a look here at the table. You can see the Keysight Standards Lab calibrations on the right-hand side. The first row, primary lab standards. What distinguishes these from our other calibrations is that we use either a primary standard or one step removed from a primary standard. That's where we get the really good accuracy and the really low measurement uncertainties. Moving down to measurement guard band, if the device you send in has a specification and part of the job is to check and see whether it passed or failed, we will apply an expanded measurement uncertainties guard band. However, if it is an item which requires only a characterization, such as a power sensor when you're looking at the calibration factor, then we simply provide the calibration factor and the uncertainty associated with that. You will receive always both the data that we measured and the measurement uncertainties, and because we are accredited in all of the parameters corresponding to these measurements, you will receive the accreditation body symbol. And then moving down into the standards compliance, the deliverables I've just indicated to you are what it takes to meet ISO 17025, and they also meet both of the Z540 standards, the old dash one and the new dot three, as well as easily passing anything that's in ISO 9001. So from a standards compliance standpoint, you're very well covered. If any of the services that I have described look interesting to you, I encourage you to either contact your service representative from Keysight or contact one of our call centers, and we will be glad to look up whether we're able to take care of the device that you have. And if that looks good to you, we'd be happy to make a quotation. Thank you very much for listening.